In my previous video, I have done the haploid diploid, the chromosome number, allosome, autosome. All these ideas I have given to you. And in today's video, I will start with the topic of structure of eukaryotic chromosome. Or in general, we can say structure of chromosome. Generally, if you draw a chromosome, it will look like this. It is having two arms and one central portion that is holding these two arms. These two arms are termed as the chromatid. And the central portion is termed as centromere. Okay, so at first, let us go for the term chromatid. What is this chromatid? This chromatid is two symmetrical, longitudinal, intertwisted, filamentous tube-like structure. And these are being bound together at the centromere at the primary constitution region. This region is termed as primary constriction. Okay, and what is the function of this chromatin? During cell division, this chromatin go apart from each other, or they get separated or go away from each other. Okay, so this is the chromatin. Next, we are going for the next region, that is this primary constriction. What is this primary constriction? It is a constricted region of the chromosome which contains the centromere. See this cylindrical, circular structure, centromere. Now this, at a particular position, now this primary constriction divides the chromosome into two arms. Okay, and what is the function of this primary constriction? It holds this centromere. Okay. Now the next part is that centromere. What is this centromere? It is a dense coiled part within the primary constriction. It is a dense coiled circular part within the primary constriction. What is the function of it? It is responsible for the attachment of spindle fiber with the chromatid during the cell division. Okay. So what is actually being over here? That this centromere is actually helping the in the process of the cell division. It is helping to hold the spindle fiber during the cell division process. Next, we will move on to the next part, that is the secondary constriction. Secondary constriction, it is another constriction apart from the primary constriction. It can be present in one arm or can be present in both the arms. It is the site where nucleolus actually originates. Okay, it is the site where the nucleolus lies, and it can be present in both the sides. And the nucleolus, along with the secondary constriction region, it forms nucleolar organizer region. Okay. Next is that the satellite, another part of the chromosome. Satellite. What is this satellite? It is a round or elongated knob-like part beyond the nucleolar organizer. Okay, which is present in some chromosomes can be absent also, and this remains connected with the rest of the chromosome by a thin filament. Okay, and the chromosomes which are containing the satellite, these chromosomes are termed as the sac chromosome. Okay, sac chromosome. And what is the function of it? That it plays a vital role in the formation of the nucleolus after cell division. It helps in the formation of the nucleolus. We know what is a nucleolus. It is a part of a nucleus. Next is that telomere. What is telomere? It is the terminal part of the chromosome. That is terminal end. Either of one end. Okay. And what is the function of it? It protects the terminal part. It prevents the two end of the chromosome from sticking together so that they does not get stick with each other. And it also takes place, or it also plays an important part in the DNA replication. So this was all about the part of the chromosome and along with them their function. Now in general we will see about, or we will go through the function of the chromosome. First function is that it is responsible for cell division, because the chromosomes will separate from each other, and the spindle fiber which are formed from the centriole, they will actually drag or help to move the chromosomes from each other. If the chromosomes will not move from each other, the cell will not get the chromosomal content and the cell division will not form. So obviously it helps in the formation of the cell division. Next is that it is containing the DNA, which is responsible for the inheritance. And number three, that it controls the cellular metabolism directly or indirectly by the formation of the protein, and it undergoes crossing over, causing variations, causing mutations within the chromosomal structure. Sex chromosome plays in an important role in the determination of the sex, as well as autosome controls all the somatic characters of our body. So this was all about the function and the structure of the chromosome. I hope in this much you have understood. Okay, in the next video I will continue with the next part of the chapter. Thank you.